This channel is supported by my Patreon page. If you want to get exclusive content every other day, then head over to patreon.com/GizEdwards and donate just a dollar a month. Thanks. On with the video. It feels strange to be making this video. Like, genuinely. The internet moves so quickly that if you're gone for a week, it feels like you've been gone for a month. If you go away for a month, it feels like it's been six. And if you go away for a year, it feels like an eternity. Today, this very day, marks the 10-year anniversary of my very first video upload. 10 years has gone by like that. So, in honor of my very first video coming out on YouTube 10 years ago, I'm going to be talking about a brief history of GizEdwards, the YouTube channel, about things that you may or may not know about, you know, this old channel. So let's start by looking at my very first video. At the time of recording that video, I had a camera, which was, it wasn't even a phone camera, it was like a point and shoot, you know, type of camera. And it didn't have a flip screen, that's way too advanced back then. So I had to literally do that. And the only way that I could record it is if I put it up on a stack of books and then kind of like lent it down over like that, and then I could have a look at, you know, the Rubik's Cube and do the Rubik's Cube underneath. But the problem was that back then, 10 years ago, a point and shoot camera was literally just for photographs. So my brother's camera that I borrowed could only shoot 1 minute at a time. So I had to make sure that I could do the Rubik's Cube in under a minute. And luckily enough, I had just learned how to do that. Nowadays, my personal best has been 19 seconds. Actually, I probably got a Rubik's Cube. There we go. Right, that should be nice and mixed up. I don't know exactly how long that was. The next video that I made on this channel was actually a video response to another YouTuber called Dan Brown, someone who I always used to watch and someone that I always used to follow very closely. And I think actually he made the tutorial that taught me how to do the Rubik's Cube as well. Hey Dan Brown, this is Giz Edwards and this is a video response to superheroes. I've given it quite a lot of thought and I thought of three possible superpowers I'd want. One of them being omnilinguistic, understand any language automatically, get paid a lot of money to translate, you know. In the past on YouTube, some of you may be too young to remember, but there was a time in which you could link, there was like a section underneath the video that you're watching, in which people could post videos and link them as a video response. But the problem with that though is that, of like with anything, people come and abuse the system. And this way that they abused this system was to get this thing called reply girls, pretty much. I've really missed this opportunity to be able to link a video as a video response, because it was a great way to build a community. You didn't need like a forum page to be able to do cross links and like try and build a community. You could just link it in the video below. It was great. And my third video on this channel was about False Awakenings, my first ever lucid dreaming video, or lucid dreaming kind of video. Just FYI, the introductionary music in that video is copyrighted and it's U2. Still haven't found what I'm looking for. Now you know. Hey everyone, my name is Giz Edwards and I'm gonna tell you about a strange lucid dream that I had last night. Little piece of trivia is that all of those three videos were filmed in the same house. Because as you may know, I've moved house quite a lot of times, but those three videos were filmed in the same house. The reason I was able to record such a long video for the lucid dreaming one was because my brother had a webcam and I used that webcam and it could record for longer videos because it went straight into the computer, not a point and shoot. The other video in which I was talking about superpowers, Dan Brown's video, by the way, those superpowers still stand. I probably have telekinesis more than anything now, but, you know, pretty much still stand. That was filmed in my bedroom, and the one in which I did the Rubik's Cube for some unknown reason is filmed in the kitchen. Don't know why. But here's an interesting thing. Some of you diehard fans may know that none of those videos were actually my first video. You probably see that on my about page, my channel was launched in March, I think, of 2007. And from there, that's when I started creating videos. But the problem with it was that all of my videos that I was creating were all like showcasey videos, videos that I wanted to like showcase me as a talent, you know. I did a lot of guitar and singing. I did a lot of videos like presenting stuff. I did a lot of news stuff. I did a lot of just different bits and pieces trying to find my footing in the whole wonderful world of YouTube. I did very random videos and I found that people weren't sticking around for my videos because they were like, well, he made a video on doing a guitar cover and now he's doing a video on Lucid Dreaming and then he's doing a video on this and then he's doing a video on that. What is the consistency with this YouTuber? So I would find that they would unsubscribe. What I did is I saw the things that people were mostly looking at, and that was guitar covers and Lucid Dreaming. I remember one time I did a video in which I was talking on helium. That's gone. I focused mainly on music, but then there was a point in the YouTube timeline in which people were getting penalized and getting copyright strikes on their channel for putting a video of a cover of a song. And because I thought of this as a long-term career, I thought I cannot get to that point. I need to be able to have no copyright strikes on my channel. So I deleted every single video that had music, me playing a cover. I deleted loads of videos. I went through a purge of them. What I should have done was just unlist them or make them privatized. But, you know, you live and learn. So all of those videos that I made before and all of the videos that were in between lots of videos, there were videos filling it out, bulking it out. But I got rid of a lot of them. You can see a few examples of those in my 100 video. There's a few like little clips like dispersed around in which you go, hang on, I've never seen that video. It's because of that.
I'm not sure how you would come across this video, but you have, and well done, because you have seen an untapped gold mine of entertainment. It's untapped because it's not there yet. Check the look.
Majestic, isn't it? I was in a few bands back in the day, and Lucid Dreaming really helped me with music because I was learning how to play the guitar and I was playing music in my dreams as well. So it really did focus on that. And I remember the first video of mine that went over 1,000 views, and that was me playing a song called Drifting, written by Andy McKee.
Yo, this one's called, like, Death on a System or something.
Then I started to do other covers as well. And occasionally you can see a video in which I just sneak in, like playing a little bit of guitar or ukulele.
I guess now it's time for me to come back. I feel it's time. I bless the rains down in Africa. It's time to get this silly misconception out of the way. You wanna know if you're lucid dreaming or you just slept the night away?
Maybe I could play some old-fashioned rock songs when I'm in the body of a child, or I can go. Baby! Sometimes I sleep. Sometimes the night will take me. The people like me always go their separate ways. Sometimes you tell the by the bottle that you drink. It's a time when you're alone. All you do is sing. So I'm a cowboy on a steel horse I ride. I'm wanted. Wanted. So when I figured out that I was going to focus on Lucid Dreaming, that's when I did the purge of all this lovely music. Shame, really. If I had to pick a video which I find truly disgusting when I watch it, apart from the video about, you know, false awakenings, because I think that's just terribly awful. I'd probably say that it was either Stuck in a Lucid Dream or Tips on How to Stay Awake. Both of these videos I found dull, dry, and boring. I cannot watch them now because they are so terrible that I don't know how it became as popular as they do. Especially Stuck in a Lucid Dream. I know it's got like an interesting title, but it's got 200,000 views now, which is a bit mental.
Ooh, wobbly cam. Hey everyone, recently I finished a project called 84 Hours. It's a sleep deprivation project in which I tried to stay awake for 84 hours straight. After I finished, a lot of people were asking me.
My favourite video that I've ever made, there's been a few. I've liked meditation, really enjoyed my step-by-step guide to meditation, but there was a period of time in which I was making really good content over, you know, a stretch, and it was because I finally figured out the way that I want to record videos in the future, and that isn't just like this, it isn't just doing vlogs or, you know, what stuff like that. I really liked doing top 5 videos in which I talked about top 5 thoughts and feelings that I think about a certain subject. Like, you've got things like prolonging lucidity, or top 5 aliens, or top 5 alien reptiles. You've got things like how to raise up the levels of lucidity. This whole timeline of like 2016, I think my videos were really well made, and I really enjoyed the videos that I was making. And even now, when I watch back at the videos, especially when I'm doing an exclusive video for Patreon, link in the description box below, but when I'm doing one of those and I come across one of these videos that in between this period of time, I think, damn, I was really good. I preferred that than I do with this kind of thing. So I may in the future go back to something similar to that. Okay, so last week I briefly mentioned the levels of lucidity and how to recognize that you're in a lucid dream whilst you're in the dream. Today I'm going to expand on how you can raise from one level of lucidity into another. It's going to be a difficult video to think through. It was a difficult video for me to word, so notepad people, not literally, but just keep your ears open. Today we're concentrating on the dialed method. So, layer one. This is when you wake up as soon as you figure out that the world around you is all but a dream. My favourite video series that I made was my vlogs. I went on holiday with the woman. Went on holiday and I vlogged something every single day for like 10 days. Went to Lyme Regis, I went and did fossil hunting, I went then to Amsterdam, and then after that I went to Germany. And each thing was something. I just really enjoyed that experience of making those videos. It's a shame that they didn't get the recognition of like my other videos, but it's understandable because, you know, it evolves over time, you know? So I think the real question is, what's next? What's next for this channel? I think I've finally figured out my groove, how I make a video well and how I make a video that's, you know, that I enjoy watching. If I enjoy watching it and I'm not too critical over something, then I think it's a good video, full stop. The 2016 kind of vibe that I had is something that I want to go back to. That is an incredibly wide shot. Let's go back to that. I've been working in retail now for pretty much ever. I've managed to save up enough money and I'm moving house soon so that I can take time off. I am quitting. I am leaving my job on April the 5th. That's a genuine thing. That is a sentence. That's a statement. So I'm leaving work and I think I'm taking about a year off. And the reason I'm doing this is because this point in my life, this channel that I've got set up and the surrounding projects that I do, they're all going somewhere. But I really need and want to dedicate all the time that I have into pushing that forward, which I can't really do if I'm at work, if you understand. Like tomorrow, instead of spending the whole day filming or something, I've got to go to work, which sucks. It does pay the bills, but it sucks. So as of the 6th of April, I'm going to be a full-time YouTuber. Mental. That is a mental sentence. And of course, with the help of you guys on Patreon as well, I sincerely, from the bottom of my heart, I thank you all for being supportive of me on Patreon. You can get lots of perks and stuff, so check the link out in the description box below. You get exclusive videos every other day. Like, genuinely, I'm not lying about that. That's a fact. I'm gonna sneeze in a minute. So hopefully by the time this video comes out, I've handed in my notice at work, given them a couple months head start, and I've made the necessary arrangements to be able to do this. This is a real thing. I know that on YouTube, over the last 10 years, I've made promises and I've fallen short of those promises all the time, mainly due to like upload schedules and stuff. Legitimately, it's just... I was rubbish at focusing on what to do. But recently, I'd say probably over the last year, especially from September, October, November of last year, 2017, I really learned a lot about the process of making YouTube videos and how much time and dedication you could put into a project to be able to push it out for an outcome. And because of this, I think it's June the 17th, I've asked the $5+ Patreon supporters their thoughts, made a poll, and they've kind of come up with this agreement in which I was going to rush everything. I was going to do it on May, the start of May, I'm going to change my upload schedule, but I'm listening to them because they help out because of the Patreon perk they've got, and June 17th, I'm changing my upload schedule. So instead of a video every other day, like I'm doing now, and a video every other day on Patreon exclusive, I'm changing it to this. Sunday, top 5 video. Monday, a lucid dreaming video. Tuesday, a video about a paranormal topic. Wednesday, a podcast with a special guest. Every single week. Thursday, a dream vlog. Friday is a day in which I just do a topical video, like in 2 days' time I've got a video coming out about Jake Paul and Logan Paul and my thoughts and feelings about that, so kind of like that. Then Saturday, the last day, will be the vlog that encompasses the whole of the week, so I'll be vlogging as I'm doing this. So hopefully with that, I'll, you know, it won't be too boring, you won't get sick of lucid dream videos, I won't get sick of lucid dream videos, and everything can move forward at, you know, evolve. That's all I've wanted to do with this channel, is just evolve with the times. That plan might change slightly. It's a rough draft, but as a whole, I'm pretty happy with the upload schedule that I've written for myself. If you want to be a part of the creation process like I described earlier, then Patreon is probably the best bet. And I want to say from the bottom of my heart, wow, 10 years on YouTube. I'd love to take all the credit, but I can't, because I wouldn't be here. I would be here. Would I? I don't know. I wouldn't be here as much. I wouldn't be able to take that next step into full-time employment self-sufficiently without you guys. And that means a lot to me. It's been a very long journey, and you've been here from the ups and the downs and all the road bumps, especially over the last couple of years. Last year was a pretty big bump. The 5 years before that was a huge bump as well. So yeah, I'd like to say thank you to everyone. Thank you all. And until next time, tomorrow on Patreon or the day after here, take care of yourself. Bye! Now it's time for me to tell you about Young Nasty Man, arch-rival and nemesis of Wonder Boy, with powers comparable to Wonder Boy! What powers, you ask? I don't know, how about the power of flight? That do anything for you? Flirtation, Holmes. How about the power to kill a yak from 200 yards away? Power to move ya. It's the